Jason Pearson, and I draw comic books for a living.
Nice.
I also do stuff for movies and video games, but that's mostly comics. You know, it's funny, I always loved comics. I didn't know the process of getting into comics, although. But in 1989, a group of friends, I was living in Las Vegas at the time, a group of high school friends were going out to this show called San Diego Comic Con. And I'd only been to one other comic book convention that was in Las Vegas, and I'd met Mike Zack, and I'd met a couple of other artists that were there. And so I was like, oh, you mean there's a convention that have more of those kind of artists? Maybe Mike Golden be there, maybe so-and-so be there. They weren't, but the point was, like, I brought my stuff along just to see, and like, but if I even had a bit of talent to get into the industry. And some of the guys that I talked to were like, you need to shape this up, you need to tighten this up, but you're on the right track. So a year later, you know, after work, I was working at an architecture company, running blueprints to the various construction sites. And but at night, I would do sequential artwork. And I came back the following year, and I broke it.
Wait a minute.
And that was it. It was a little bit of excitement, but it was really mostly, I understood, like, the things that I thought were in my pencils didn't show up in the inks, and how much color can change the whole vibe and feel of things. Even the control freak in me kind of started seeing things like, oh, okay, I need to redo this, I need to shape that up. It was more of a mechanical process than really, more than excitement. It was just like, oh, neat, the book's out, awesome. But I was relatively unknown. It was more exciting to when I made it to DC and saw my Legion of Superheroes work, because I was working on a book that I had read before I got into the industry. So, and it was fun to work with Keith Giffen. So, I mean, I used to use a brush a lot more. Now I use tech pens, and I still use India ink, but I don't, my hands in the late 90s started to cramp up a lot bad from using a brush. And I heard the horror stories that, like, Bernie Wrights and certain inkers they have gone through by constantly using a brush and how you grip certain utensils. It's like, no, I want to save myself from those damaging prospects. So sometimes I play with the 3D modeling for, like, backgrounds, just because it's like, I know that's where it's going. So it's kind of fun, like with SketchUp and 3ds Max, and try something out. Hey, take care, guys. It's like just understanding how that all works. I've played with it, but by the time I'm done playing with it, it's like I could have drawn that page by hand. So. I'm always the guy that bounces around, tries different things. Much to the dismay of my editors when I'm like turning in pages late, but it's like kind of what keeps the fun in the industry. So just every story I work on, how to approach it in a refreshing manner that I'll enjoy as much as the readers will enjoy. You know, yes, it is a commercial feel, but I'm the one drawing it, you know? And like, not every day do you want to draw. You can't put creativity on a schedule. So some days you want to draw, some days you don't, but you got to find some way to get the work done. And that's usually what you got to do. It always starts with the thumbnails. I read the story two or three times. Just so that I pick up on everything that the writer's wanting to do. If I get a chance to talk to the writer, I will. And say, well, what's the main theme you're going for? Are you trying to create a mood? Are you trying to keep it open? Whatever. So I know how to convey my storytelling in the right direction. Other times, although, I don't get to talk to the writer, so I just go ahead and do my thing. After that, it's like doing the thumbnails, and then I can really go straight to pencils. You know, I like to keep the energy there. So I find myself, if I keep creating these levels of, like, doing the thumbnails and doing light pencils, then doing tighter pencils, and then inking it, it takes the energy out of it. The artwork starts to stiffen up. It gets to be too refined. So I like, especially with inking my stuff, I like to cut to the chase as soon as I can. I'll just draw some things loose and some things tight, and then I finalize everything with a pen.